generally nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, which belongs to 50A group. These chemical substances or these elements reacts with hydrogen and produces two different hydrates. EH3, EH5 type of hydrates resulting from 50A group elements, where E is equals to 50A group elements like nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Means hydrogen or 5th A group elements reacts with hydrogen and produces hydrides of general molecular formula EH3 and EH5. Here these hydrates NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3 and PIH3. The stability of these hydrates from ammonia to bismuth trihydrate decreases. From left to right, stability of hydrates decreases. Whereas reducing character of these hydrates increases. Whereas basicity of these hydrates decreases. So what is our clarity regarding these statements? Ammonia is more stable than PH3, is more stable than ASH3, is more stable than SBH3, is more stable than BH3, like this. Whereas reducing character increases, means ammonia is never works as strong reducing agent, whereas BH3 can works as strong reducing agent because ammonia is mild reduction reagent. Next one, basicity of these hydrates decreases from left to right. Here ammonia is a strong base than BiH3, bismuth trihydrate. So these are the expected hydrates resulting from when 5th A group elements reacts with hydrogen atom. Whereas one more, reactivity of 5th A group elements with oxygen. These 5th A group elements generally reacts with oxygen and produces E2O3 and E2O5 type of oxides. Reacts with oxygen and produces oxides. Reacts with hydrogen and produces hydrates. Here, except nitrogen, remaining elements of the same group can form E2O5 type of oxides. Rarely nitrogen can also exhibit N2O5, but well-known oxides are N2O3, nitrogen trioxide. Not only this, nitrogen is also produces some oxides by reacting with this nitrous oxide, nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide, N2O3, N2O5, etc. So these are the some species resulting oxides resulting from 5th A group elements. Next one, phosphorus can also produces P2O3, P2O5, phosphorus trioxide and phosphorus pentoxide type of oxides resulting from the reaction of these 5th A group elements with oxygen. And next one, the 5th A group elements also reacts with halogens and produces halides. Reaction of 5th A group elements with halogens. So the producing halogens are EX3 and EX5 type of species produced from here, where E is equals to, again, any 5th A group element: nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. Again the same concept. In EX3 formula, the oxidation state is plus 3 and here is plus 5 oxidation state. Only EX5 type of halogens or halide species produced from phosphorus, arsenic, stibium and bismuth, whereas EX3 type of halides are produced from nitrogen, phosphorus and remaining, for example, NCl3, a rarely identified nitrogen trichloride, whereas the well-known trichlorides of phosphorus are, chlorides of phosphorus are PCl3, PCl5, phosphorus trichloride, phosphorus pentachloride and stibium hexafluoride and bismuth hexafluoride, etc. These are some halides resulting from the reaction of 50A group elements with halogen atom. Now, among these, and one more type, the same halogens, the same elements, 50A group elements are also reacts with metals. They reacts with metals and produces calcium nitride, CA3N2, calcium nitride, whereas CA3PO4 taken twice, whereas CA3P2, calcium phosphide, calcium nitride, calcium phosphide, whereas the arsenic will also reacts with sodium, Na3As, sodium arsenide, whereas zinc Zn3Bi twice, or zinc antimonide. So all these are the chemical substances resulting from 50A group elements. When these 50A group elements reacts with calcium, sodium, zinc, magnesium, etc., they results their respective products. So this is the chemical reactivity of 50A group elements. So remember, the most important element among all is nitrogen and phosphorus. So let us learn about the next concept, dinitrogen. Dinitrogen. What is dinitrogen? We can show it as N2 or nitrogen molecule. Dinitrogen is also called as nitrogen molecule. This dinitrogen or nitrogen molecule commercially produced from air, because with respect to volume in percentage, 78% of nitrogen present in air upon fractional distillation, we can separate nitrogen from their respective counterparts of air. Nitrogen, dinitrogen separated from its counterpart, that is next coming one, oxygen, because nitrogen's boiling point is less than oxygen's boiling point. Hence, this is the reason why nitrogen will be first separated out than oxygen.